Hello, everyone. I'm Haichen Shen from University of Washington. Today, I'm going to present our work, Fast Video Classification via Adaptive Cascading of Deep Models. This is a joint work with Seungyeop, Matthai, Philipose, and Arvind, Krishnamurthy. In this paper, we are focusing on the task of recognizing entities such as objects, scene, and people in every frame of our day-to-day life videos. As we may encounter thousands of such entities through our life, recognition models need to recognize all of them with high accuracy. And recent advances in convolutional neural networks can achieve this. However, these CNN models are usually expensive to do inference for every frame in the video. Alternatively, we can generate simpler versions that are much cheaper and faster to execute, but they suffer from lower accuracy. So how can we reconcile this? We observe that day-to-day videos tends to have a small number of entities within a short interval. To verify this, we define one metric called dominant object count as the number of object classes that account for 80% of all objects occurrences in a 1 minute segment. We analyzed 30 day-to-day videos and split them into 1 minute segments. We found that 70% of segments have dominant object count no more than 10, and 90% have no more than 15. So can we exploit temporal skew in a video to accelerate the recognition speed while still achieving Oracle's accuracy? To exploit the skew, we propose an architecture that cascades a cheap classifier with the Oracle as follows. First, a compact model recognizes the dominant classes in the video and plus one other class. In most cases, only the compact model is executed to get the result. And when compact model predicts the input as other, we then execute the Oracle to recognize all classes. We call this entire structure as a specialized model. Now, the big problem here is that we need to do all this online based on the video we are seeing right now. So more specifically, are these online trained models accurate enough? Can we train them fast enough? And how do we determine the dominant classes at runtime without ground truth? And when exactly should we produce a specialized model? First, we use the object recognition as an example to compare the accuracy. We select two models. One is the GoogleNet, the other is the compact CNN. This compact model is unremarkable except that it is much faster than the GoogleNet. When the compact model and GoogleNet are both trained and tested on the uniformly distributed dataset, the accuracy of compact model is significantly lower than the GoogleNet. We then train the compact model to recognize five dominant classes and cascade it with the GoogleNet to form a specialized model. We test the specialized model under the skewed distribution where five classes consist of 70 to 90% in the test dataset. And it turns out that the specialized model becomes even more accurate than the GoogleNet. And even when we allow up to 20 dominant classes, the specialized model can still achieve competitive accuracy. Because we need to train this specialized model online, we need to be fast. The way we do this is by pre-training the lower layers of compact models and only retargeting the top layer at runtime for dominant classes. This is super fast, and the training only takes a few seconds. When should we switch between the Oracle and specialized model at runtime? We formulated this problem as a non-stationary contextual bandit problem with many arms. Basically, we explore the distribution by running the Oracle and exploit it by running the specialized model for that distribution. We use the window link to handle the stationarity and heuristics to detect the abrupt distribution changes. The evaluation on the movie and TV show clips shows that our algorithm can speed up the recognition by 2 to 8x with competitive accuracy. Thank you.